18-year-old Lynn was admitted to the hospital as an unconscious Jane Doe. Doctors would have to perform an emergency C-section without consent to save her from the life-threatening condition of eclampsia.
We need the intubator.
And Lynn didn't even know she was pregnant.
Scalpel.
The doctor went in not knowing what he was going to find.
I need some suction here, please.
The scariest thing for me was the unknown and not knowing the baby's condition. There could be issues with the baby surviving on its own.
I have the head. And we have a baby.
Lynn gave birth to a little girl after 32 weeks of pregnancy.
Thank God we delivered a healthy baby, 5 pounds, 15 ounces. It was a great relief. It was a very special moment. At least one of the two patients was doing very well.
My blood pressure would not stop spiking.
What's your mag drip currently at?
2 grams.
My blood pressure was so high, they thought I could go into cardiac arrest.
The cart?
Ultimately, that would kill me.
It's dropped.
She's dropped.
I was concerned for her. Obviously, she was alone. She wasn't able to even comprehend what was happening to her. She did have a significant chance of dying.
Out of town for the 4th of July weekend, Lynn's mum hadn't heard from her daughter in 2 days.
I mean, this is really getting to me now. I'm going, oh my gosh, wait, where is my daughter? I don't know where she is. I went to bed worrying about the worst. Her life was flashing before my eyes. Where is she? Where is she? Where is she? Where is she? It was terrible. I was in that twilight zone kind of place where you're not in control and you don't know what's happening and you feel like you're living in a nightmare. Mothers want to know where the babies are. Even when they're 18.
On the 6th of July, Lynn finally regained consciousness.
Next thing I remember, I woke up with a tube down my throat, bandaged all over my stomach, and I was like, where am I? I was scared. I didn't know what was going on.
You're in the hospital?
The nurses began to ask me, what's your name? You know, where are you from?
You're okay. Your baby is perfectly fine.
The nurses said, don't worry, your daughter's healthy and beautiful. I immediately was thinking, I don't have a daughter, but I couldn't speak because the tube was in my throat.
I'm gonna unhook you so you can talk. Just relax. It's right out. Here we go.
I wasn't pregnant.
What are you talking about?
You have the wrong room.
Your baby's right outside.
No.
And she's like, what are you talking about? Your daughter is right here. And then they wheeled her in. They checked my bracelet and they checked her little foot and they were like, no, this is yours.
There's your baby.
Oh my God.
She's definitely yours. You didn't know you were pregnant?
No.
And they explained everything that happened, and then I immediately became petrified.
Do you want to hold her?
No.
I was so scared that if I would have held her, I probably would have, like, shook to death. I was feeling a rush of emotions I can't even explain. All of a sudden, I was a mom. It's like someone rings your doorbell and leaves it there. I didn't know what to think. I panicked. I flipped. I was like, that's not my child. Do I have to put her up for adoption? I can't keep her. I'm too young. What am I going to do? How am I going to raise this child when I can't even take care of myself? I was like, you guys cannot do this to me. This is not mine. This is not my child. I said, I need to speak with my mother immediately.
Hello?
I get a call on my cell phone. Well, where is she? Well, she had a car accident, and she's in the ICU unit. I went, what? I got on that plane into that airport as soon as I could.
I was freaking out. I was scared. I pretty much ultimately fought with myself. I was thinking about adoption. But I felt like, how could I live with myself if I shipped this baby off with somebody I didn't even know? She's your child. What are you thinking this for? And then, well, how can you? You're too young. I was sitting in the hospital room, and after that hour of fighting with myself emotionally, I just completely fell in love with her. She was just gorgeous. Like a little baby doll, like this big. That was it. She was mine.
Can I hold her?
I was like, oh my God, this is mine. I'm gonna take care of her. I don't care what it takes me. Care.
Marie.
I kind of looked at her and she just looked like a Marie.
It's right through there.
Oh my God, Mom, babe. Are you okay?
All honesty, I didn't think she was ready for that. How's this young girl who wants to be out with her friends going to start taking responsibility for this life?
I knew that if she didn't want this child, that I would be on my own. And I needed my mom.
Oh, my God.
It was a shock. It was... it was the biggest shock I've ever had in my life.
Oh, my God. Hi, baby.
I couldn't believe that was my grandbaby. I just was like, oh, my gosh. Cutest thing, prettiest little thing. She's just melted my heart ever since.
Oh, my God. Oh, honey. Oh, she's beautiful.
Lynn called me later that day. She was like, I'm a mommy. And I thought Lynn was drugged. And when I walked into the room, there's baby Marie next to Lynn. And I was like, oh, my God, she had a child. And I couldn't believe it.